The office of the president yesterday announced lawyer Frank Nyakana Rusa as the interim executive director ED of Kampala Capital City Authority following the dismissal of Dorothy Chisaka. The authority's legal director was announced alongside two other contemporary appointees assigned in place of the dismissed KCCA deputy ED engineer David Luimbazi and KCCA director of public health Dr. Daniel Okello. The Minister for Kampala and Metropolitan Affairs, Minsa Kabanda, spoke about the new development in the KCCA leadership.
We are all aware that there were certain changes which were made on the 23rd, so we had to replace tentatively these vacant places in the KCCA. That is Director KCCA, Deputy Executive Director, and the Director Health. So they have been replaced by three people. That is, Noele is the deputy director, Frank Rusa is the new executive director, tentatively, and Dr. Zarango is the new executive director for health, tentatively.
The announcement of Nyakana as the interim ED came at a time when councillors were stranded and locked outside the council chambers yesterday. Led by Speaker Zahara Luyirika, the city councillors also blamed Lord Mayor Erias Lukwago and the Minister Kabanda for locking them outside the city chambers.
Lord Mayor, aleme kutuwa report ya chitezi kubantu wa wafa neka sasira alimu kuta abantu wa Kampala. Naba langa bachi ali wansimu takarira kasasiro. Banange no ya akola. Oyo no Lord Mayor banange, ayino kumuno onyako. Eya mulemesezo kweta report mu council.
Councillors later convened in the Speaker's office for council business. They were informed that council business was put to a halt since the executive director had not assumed office. The presiding judge, Isaac Mowata, yesterday continued the hearing of the case in which Kampala businessman Henry Katanga was murdered. The defense bench continued cross-examining the police's forensic expert, Mr. Andrew Mubiru, which revealed contradictions in his testimony. The contradiction was evidenced in the serial number of the alleged killer's gun, which the defense found did not match the one for the gun he examined. Asked if he examined the baton and the stick which were brought as exhibits, he said he did not. The defense lawyer found this anomaly to be deliberate to hide evidence that Molly Katanga was tortured. This is the seventh interrogation of Andrew Mubiru in the murder case of Henry Katanga. The presiding judge adjourned the hearing to 1st October 2024.
I've interacted with the complainant. And we are suggesting that this matter be given from the tools that the court will come.
And every time I've been ready to hear a case, but her judgments have been sold. Today the state is saying that they have directed further inquiries to be done, which must be done anyway.
I understand.
So the delays are not caused by the judiciary.
President William Ruto, while addressing the United Nations General Assembly yesterday, revealed that Kenya is committed to completing its deployment of a stabilization force in violence-torn Haiti by January 2025. Ruto appealed for greater funding to assist other contributing countries.
Appeal to all member states to stand in solidarity with the people of Haiti by providing necessary support either directly to MSS contributing countries or through the UN Trust Fund. I must emphasize, however, that Kenya will deploy the additional contingent towards attaining the target of all the 2,500 police officers by January next year.
The three-month-old security force to combat spiraling insecurity in the Caribbean nation is currently a Kenyan-led multinational policing operation, and changing it into a UN-mandated force would require a Security Council vote.